It's 6:30 on a Sunday morning. Running up and down this bridge is quite tiring. That's it, we're starting to come through the mist and the fog now, and the blue skies are appearing. I am getting my hair cut. Few days. I've had this hair for like since lockdown. Tricky trying to swim with one hand.
I know.
That's the Friday swim done. Now starts the walk up Ben Braggy to the Duke of Sutherland Monument. Ingrid is saying, don't get me in the camera, and then walks where the camera is. I'm hoping as we emerge out at the top, we come out above the clouds. That is the plan. Oh no, we're near the top. There's the monument. No! It's cold, we've got goosebumps. Reynolds has kicked in, and I'm wearing shorts. The clouds started to lift. So we've turned round, we're heading back up the way we came, and we can actually see the monument in the distance.
So today we're going to be having a look at the Innovate Trail Fly. Hi everyone, thanks for coming along to watch the video. It means you can go over there.
So it's Monday, and I'm trying to make a video for this getting back to running. So getting back to running has had quite a few hiccups along the way. It's certainly not been as straightforward as I was hoping it would be. But I'm out today, short run, probably about 3.5k. And that's a weird thing. I'm now dealing in K instead of miles. What's that all about?
About 10 days ago, I felt a sharp pain in my side.
Jake's up the top. Oh, blimey. Balanced on a rock here. Fairly big rock, so I shouldn't lose my footing, but...
Yeah, it's very bouldery.
Very bouldery.
The path has just disappeared.
Yeah. And now it carries on like this for a fair while over this ride, and then a fair bit further again. We're off for a walk stroke run, so we're going to walk up and run down Mealy Buckle. We're getting attacked by the bees. Jake's just telling me to move quicker. I can't move any quicker. I'm knackered. That's us at the top. Bang on 3K to the top. So this is going to be 6K all in all, up and down. Stood in the middle of the harbour on the pointy outfit as being as visible as possible. No idea where Ingrid is. Oh, it's nice to be out. 15 degrees, windy, and I'm on a trail. Hooray! So the reason I'm doing a 7-hour drive is to go and attempt to run the Rochdale Half Marathon.
Got down there, got to Rochdale. Well, I didn't get to Rochdale, never actually got to Rochdale.
Out doing what used to be my regular run, which is a 9K loop with some hills. It's just be the first time I've tried to do this since before March. Bit by bit, just got to keep chipping away. Let's get chipping. It's taken me just over 7 months to get back to doing this loop. Well, I've just done it. Things are moving in the right direction. Woohoo!
So I've pretty much been using this every day for the last seven days. So things I found out along the way, things found out initially.
Lately, yeah, my running has pretty much almost stopped. I've been signed off work, so hernias have kicked in. Been up to the hospital, met with the surgeon, told me, yes, you do need an operation fairly urgently. I'm on a priority list.
Today we have Mike Wardian with us, who has got such an extensive background in running. Can you recommend your favourite two exercises for runners out there that they're going to take the most out of? If you could only pick a couple of exercises.
Yeah, man. I'd say there's probably three that I do every day that I think are really helpful. So
yeah. How you doing, everyone? Thanks for joining us. So today we've got Holly Rush on the channel. What sort of things would you recommend people do each day that they can fit in and they're going to benefit from?
Okay, well, this is one, it's not just for everyone, but this is something that we've actually done with a couple of clients this season.
Yeah.
And this is probably targeted more at ultra runners or people who are going to be doing hilly stuff.
Yeah.
Walking lunges are your friends. And you could do this at home. You don't even need to go to a gym.
I like the fact it's got buttons and it's not touch screen, so if it's cold, you've got gloves on. It's just nice and simple to use. I've worked in retail for decades, and the one thing that does my head in more than anything else, all these big brands, everything they sell you comes in single-use wrapped plastic, and it's such a waste. So it's so refreshing to get something through the post that is in a bag like this, which is a paper bag.
And today we have Ian Sharman with us.
Yeah. I also would say that a really good exercise just in general, not just for runners, but there's helping to get a whole load of different areas working together, is pull-ups and chin-ups.
So today we have Ellie Green with joining us.
And that's going to work for your glutes. And you should be using your glutes when you're running because they're the biggest muscle in your body.
So that was it, the end of 2021. Good riddance, you were rubbish. 2022, already looking better. I've got my operation for my hernia the next few days. So hopefully after a short recovery, I'll be back to doing what I love to do. So thanks for watching the review of the year and have a great 2022, everyone. Bye now.